that list and why does it continue to remain on the list of such organizations that is kept by the Secretary of State? Well, I think it's pretty openly acknowledged that the reason the MEK was placed on that list during the Clinton administration was to curry favor with Iran and to use the designation as a way of entering into dialogue with the Iranian regime. And I'm sorry to say that even during the administration that I served in, it's reported that MEK continued to remain on the list for the same misguided reason, that if we kept MEK on the list of terrorist organizations, a list, by the way, that includes the IRGC, the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps, then somehow the Iranians would be more willing to engage in constructive negotiations to end their nuclear program. Now, that is a sorry and cynical reason for branding as terrorists a group of people who, so far as anyone can tell, are interested only in bringing to their country the blessing of the kind of liberty that we enjoy in this country. But it's pretty obvious also that it doesn't work. The Iranian regime is now in the enviable position of having the United States designate as a terrorist organization a group of Iranians who are a threat to that regime and of limiting that group's activities. In other words, the Iranians now have the great Satan working for them. Which brings us, I guess, to the question of what is the practical effect under the law of an organization being on that list. An organization on that list is subject to having its assets in the United States seized, and it is nearly impossible for the organization to raise money in this country because anyone who contributes to it can be prosecuted and convicted for providing material assistance to a terrorist organization. Beyond that, and particularly in the United States, people are concerned that even appearing at a rally sponsored by an organization that is called a foreign terrorist organization or giving it any help at all can taint them. People who are not aware of the details of the case, including many diaspora Iranians, may feel reluctant to support MEK. And of course, the continued designation of MEK as a terrorist organization gives great comfort and legitimacy to the Iranian regime by putting on the sidelines an organization that is potentially a grave threat to the regime. What's to be done? Well, as I'm sure many of you know, there's an ongoing case in which MEK has challenged the designation. In July, the U.S. Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia Circuit issued an opinion, essentially sending the matter back to the State Department, to the Secretary of State, and asking her to reevaluate whether MEK should be on this list. But the court did something more than that. It expressed a good deal of skepticism, at least about the non-classified information that was put before the court and shared with MEK, and which MEK could therefore rebut. Without getting into a whole lot of detail, the Secretary of State may choose to base her determination entirely on classified information if she wants, and then nobody knows why she made the decision. But she did